गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द वीकली कमोडिटी ऑडियोकास्ट। आई एम कायना चैनवाला फ्रॉम कोटक सिक्योरिटीज कमोडिटीज रिसर्च डेस्क, एंड लाइक इन एवरी एपिसोड टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑनगोइंग डेवलपमेंट्स इन द कमोडिटी मार्केट्स, फैक्टर्स इन्फ्लुएंसिंग मार्केट सेंटिमेंट्स एंड अनकवरिंग द लेटेस्ट ट्रेंड्स। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड एंड डेल्व डीपर इन दिस एवर चेंजिंग वर्ल्ड ऑफ कमोडिटीज। लास्ट वीक ग्रोइंग ऑप्टिमिज्म प्रिवेल थ्रू आउट द वीक, फ्यूल्ड बाय एक्सपेक्टेशंस ऑफ अ सॉफ्टर यूएस लेबर मार्केट दैट कुड प्रॉम्प्ट द फेडरल रिजर्व टू कट रेट्स लेटर दिस ईयर। However, this sentiment was dampened in the last session on Friday as official US jobs figures revealed continued resilience. Dollar had slipped to a two-month low of 103.99 earlier in the week as a string of downbeat labor market indicators from the US before the official jobs report on Friday reinforced bets that the Federal Reserve will be able to cut interest rates this year. Number of job openings in April declined to 8.059 million, lowest since Feb 2021, and missing the market consensus of 8.34 million, while initial unemployment claims unexpectedly jumped to their second highest levels this year in the last week of May. Also, private payrolls growth slowed more than expected to 1,52,000 in May, which is the least in 4 months and well below forecast of 175,000 and a downwardly revised 188,000 in April. Meanwhile, Bank of Canada and European Central Bank slashed rates by a quarter point this week, improving the conviction that Fed might also follow the path as inflation eases later this year. Despite the unexpectedly strong labor market report on Friday, all the three major US indices still settled for a winning week as Dow Jones, S&P 500 and Nasdaq closed the week with 0.4%, 1.3% and 2.4% advance respectively. Talking about gold prices, COMEX gold was set for a small weekly gain amid signs of weakness in the US jobs market earlier in the week. The yellow metal has been consolidating around $2,350 for the last 2 weeks as investors waited for more clues on policy path. Data released this week showed that US manufacturing activity slowed for a second consecutive month in May, while construction spending unexpectedly fell in April due to declines in non-residential activity. Also, global ETFs saw net inflows in May, ending a 12-month losing streak as investors were lured by the recent rally in prices. However, prices retreated sharply from higher levels as People's Bank of China gold buying slowed in April, rising by just 2 tons, and did not see any buying in May, ending an 18-month buying spree, thereby raising demand concerns from a sector which has been contributing to a quarter of the total demand. Bullion held by the People's Bank of China was unchanged at 72.8 million troy ounces in May, making it the first time the country has opted not to add to its reserves since October 2022. Owing to this, gold closed the week 1.4% lower, while silver tumbled nearly 4%, with more than 3% decline seen in all the base metals, as an unexpected increase in US non-farm payrolls pushed the dollar to 104.95 on Friday in a sharp rebound from 104 levels hit earlier. On the charts, MCX Gold August Futures continuous chart witnessed a decline of more than 2% on 7th June. 73,506 is now a strong hurdle for price to overcome, above which the all-time high of 74,442 is a crucial resistance. A close below 71,200 can compel prices to test 70,000. However, the intertwined lines of the Williams Alligator and the ADX having fallen from 68 to 25 since mid-April indicates a sideways trajectory in gold prices. Moving on to the oil energy complex, crude oil prices slipped to 4-month low of $72.48 per barrel earlier last week, as OPEC plans to gradually phase out 2.2 million barrels per day of voluntary cuts from October 2024 to September 2025, bothered markets amid concerns over demand and robust non-OPEC supply. Also, Saudi Aramco lowered prices for all of its oil to Asia next month in its first reduction since February, raising demand concerns in the world's top importing region. Although oil prices closed the week 2.3% lower, they still covered half of the losses and closed the week above $75 per barrel as Saudi and Russia tried to reassure markets that they may pause or reverse output agreements depending on market conditions. Moving on to natural gas, NYMEX Henry Hub gas prices rallied around 13%, the most in the non-agri commodities space, as forecasts shifted slightly warmer and as traders anticipated demand for air conditioning. According to NatGas Weather, weather forecast trended hotter, with the southern US expected to see highs in the range of 80s to 100s 100 Fahrenheit, mid 20s to 30s Celsius for 12th to 19th June. Additionally, gas flow to LNG export facilities has been on the rise, especially with the Freeport LNG plant in Texas back in operation. Markets largely ignored more than expected inventory injection in the prior week. EIA inventory data showed that US utilities added 98 BCF of gas into storage during the week, above market expectations of 89 BCF, but lower than the 5-year average change of 103 BCF. Talking about charts, on 7th June, MCX Natural Gas June Futures continuous chart breached a downward sloping trend line on the daily chart. Price is well set above the 20-day EMA and is approaching a resistance of 253. We noticed strong supports for the counter at 228, followed by a crucial swing low of 205. A close above the swing high of 243.6 must be awaited, until which the trend for the week remains for crude, it is sideways to bullish. For natural gas, the trend for the week remains sideways to bullish. Now this week, US inflation figures just ahead of FOMC meeting may test investors' nerves, as higher than expected US hiring and wage growth in May trimmed the chances for multiple rate cuts from the Federal Reserve. US non-farm payrolls expanded much more than expected by 272,000 for the month, up from 165,000 in April, and reduced the probability of a rate cut in the September meeting to 46.7% from 55.4% a day before. Also, average hourly earnings rose 4.1% year-on-year versus estimates of 3.9%. Meanwhile, unemployment rate rose to 4%, highest since January 2022. However, it is just a marginal increase from 3.9% in April. So now, FOMC economic projections and dot plot will be closely eyed this week, especially after the backdrop of rate cuts from ECB and Bank of Canada this last week. Additionally, traders will most probably focus on the upcoming Bank of Japan meeting, as it could offer insights into the potential scaling back of bond purchases, while Chinese inflation figures, particularly CPI, will be closely monitored, as they could indicate whether the nascent recovery in domestic demand persisted in May. Overall, this week, fears of delay in rate cuts following unexpectedly strong US jobs report may limit risk appetite ahead of FOMC meeting and US inflation figures. On this note, we conclude this session of Commodity Audiocast and hope that we've offered you valuable insights. So thank you so much for tuning in today, and we eagerly anticipate your presence with us again next week. Until then, happy trading. Thank you so much.